Welcome to Around a Round Table. This is the episode where your favorite guests from the Wreck My Podcast get together around a round table and talk about nothing and everything. I'm here with two guests, and a third one is on their way. He's got to get that boom, boom, boom. It's Craiger.
Boom, boom, pow.
Yep. In this context, there's no disrespect, so when she busts a rhyme, she'll break your neck. It's Ashley.
I'm out here snapping necks every day.
You're snapping the necks. I'm going to get you love drunk off my hump. I'm your host, Jordan. And Morgan's on her way. She's got a feeling tonight's going to be a good night. So she will be showing up in 1 minute, 2 minutes, 5 minutes. I don't know. But we're doing something a little bit different this week. Cam and Joe couldn't be with us.
So we're doing all Black Eyed Peas.
Yes, all Black Eyed Peas. Everything is about the Black Eyed Peas this week. But we're doing a round table. It's going to be a little bit shorter, a little, what? What are you laughing at,
Craiger? I just thought of something like, you know, from, I think, Lady and the Tramp.
Uh-huh.
We are Siamese, if you please. We are Black Eyed Peas, if you please.
We should do a whole spoof of that movie. Is that Lady and the Tramp or is that Aristocrats?
I believe it is Lady and the Tramp.
Oh, okay. I'll take your word for it. First thing I want to mention on this episode of Around a Round Table is that if you're listening to it on the day of this episode of Around a Round Table being released, we will be at the Dudes tomorrow. That's Tuesday, November 26th, doing a live show.
That is the Dudes Brewing Company in Valencia, California.
Yeah, on Town Center Drive at the Westfield Mall. So if you're in the area and you want to come check us out, we're going to be doing a little bit of bantering, but then we're going to be doing a lot of games with people who are there, getting to play the trivia with us and win beer and other swaggage.
Accoutrement.
Also, I want to mention, did you guys hear about this Nicolas Cage thing? The Nicolas Cage to star in a Nicolas Cage movie where he plays Nicolas Cage?
Yes.
That is so funny.
Isn't that Tarantino?
No, so in the movie, it's a Tarantino film that he's going out for.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I don't think Tarantino actually wrote this.
Is Tarantino directing?
Tarantino's probably going to be in it.
Okay.
Like, as playing himself. It's going to be super meta.
I am
super
so
weird.
Excited for this.
Yeah, it's going
to
be amazing.
We need to have Cam's hookup. Because it wasn't his. Didn't he say his film mentor is Nicolas Cage's brother?
Yeah, something like that.
Chris Coppola.
Yeah, a Coppola. Yeah,
one of
we
the
should we should get in the like the back stages of this.
We should
somehow.
Give him a Coppola calls.
Coppola calls. Yes, that's exactly what we should do. And maybe we could be extras in it.
That would be so
that
cool.
would be so cool.
That wouldn't be extra at all.
No, it wouldn't be. No, it would be more basic than extra. So also, I wanted to mention. Over the holiday seasons, the Patreon content's going to be a little bit more sparse because we're all busy. We all have lives. Holidays are a thing. So we want to mention to our patrons, just apologize that if there's a week or two here that we don't get some patron content out, don't worry. We'll make it twice as funny for you when we are back.
Yeah.
Which, can you do twice as much as zero?
Yeah.
Zero funny?
Double
twice
zero.
As much as zero?
Just double zero.
Double zero? Okay, I can do double zero.
That's Carmelo Anthony.
That is... Is his number a double zero?
He did for the new team he just started for. Yeah, he did.
Wow, that's douchey. Okay.
Why is double zero douchey?
I don't know because it's not a number.
I guess that's right.
They're just it's like, not. What's his number? Ooh.
No, it's more like when you see him shooting Mitch, like, ooh.
Ooh.
Oh, no.
So let's get into the segment where we're going to talk about beer. If I could hit the button on this.
Hit the button!
All right. So Ashley was kind enough to provide us with some beers that she had that we're going to try.
Thank you, Ashley.
And I'm going to try
welcome, Craiger.
To do Joe's job here. I don't know if that sounded good or not. But what this is a brewery called Three Weavers, which is in Inglewood, California, I believe. And it's a beer called Expatriate IPA. Expatriate. I'm not quite sure how you say it, but it's an IPA.
I believe it's called expedited shipping.
Expedited shipping. It is not ground shipping. It is the one you pay way too much for. You can have the rest of that. And so let me tell you a little bit about this beer. It is a 6.9% ABV. The bottom of the can says Enter Can Man, which I think is hilarious. I love when they post little notes on the bottom of the cans with the produced by date. Oh, Morgan's here. She's got a feeling it's going to be a good night. Because tonight's going to be a good night. All right. So, Morgan, welcome into the podcast.
Thank you very much.
This is a unique episode where we actually have the gender at a 50-50 ratio. So, ladies, you've done it. Equality. You can rest now. Job well done. At least on the Wreck My Podcast.
Equal pockets, equal pay.
Equal pockets, equal pay. Exactly.
There's
hashtag.
Been a lot of suffering, JJ.
Yes. So we're drinking this beer that's an IPA. It says on the can, inspired by the Three Weavers community, our West Coast IPA is bright and laden with notes of tropical fruits, brewed with two-row barley, a touch of English crystal malt, and... cheers, and loaded with new age American hops. Expatriate is home no matter where you are. It's a very weird name.
Expatriate, I think, sounds right.
Expatriate, maybe that's what it is. Do you like this, Morgan, or no?
It's okay.
You can move the microphone.
I don't want to mess up the sound of the O.
Oh, it doesn't mess up anything. Yeah, it just goes right to where you want it to be.
Okay.
Yeah. How do you like it?
I don't hate this, actually, which I'm not... I feel like it's really bad to say that I'm not a fan of beer on this podcast, but
and you probably IPAs probably aren't your favorite either, huh?
I don't really know.
Oh, okay, because you don't drink enough to know.
Yeah, no, I don't.
Okay, well, Craig, what do you think?
But
it
I don't
is?
Hate it.
Yeah, well, that's good. That's good.
Yeah,
to
I don't
not
hate
not it. Not a beer drinker doesn't hate it. That's a good review in my opinion.
Yeah,
Craig, what do you think?
For an IPA, this is not slap you across the face hoppy.
Yeah.
No, it's a very unique beer.
Yeah.
In the sense of it loses all of its hoppiness after it's out of your mouth.
Which is extremely enjoyable. Like, I'm not much of an IPA fan, but this is I'd say, I have to do the untapped out of five. So
yes.
I would give it, out of all beers, I'd give it a 3.5, 3.7.
Cool.
Out of IPAs, I give it a 4 or higher.
You need to drink more legitimate New England hazy IPAs from New England, because I thought I hated IPAs until
do
I started
they,
drinking
do they come
more
with
those.
Deflated balls or cheating?
No, because they're not with the Patriots.
Oh, these are expatriates.
Yeah,
got
these
it.
Are expatriates.
Okay.
Yeah, the expatriate. Ashley, what do you think of this one?
This is now my second time having it. The first time I was like, oh, wow, this is different. It's very hoppy, kind of citrusy at first.
Yeah.
And then you get that malt flavor. And then after it's down your throat, you don't taste anything anymore.
Nope. Yeah. Nope. That's exactly what you want in an IPA. It hits you in the front, but then doesn't linger.
It smells really good to me. It smells
Oh, it smells very floral.
Yeah,
yeah,
smells really
fruity
good.
And floral. The tropical comes through in the scent way more than in the taste, I will tell
you
that.
Definitely.
Fruit tea is what it smells like to
it,
me, it which is probably really weird.
The hop flavor is definitely West Coast style because it's very piney, but it doesn't linger, which is nice.
No, it's refreshing, which most IPAs are
cotton mouth.
If you're going to drink an IPA, you're I am trying to get drunk. Mm-hmm. That's why people drink IPAs, because they don't taste terribly good.
Well, I think people would fight you on that. But
IPAs are like salsa.
To be fair, that's
what?
I drink. So.
I do drink your IPAs.
Pretty much.
Man, you're more of a man than I am.
IPAs, and well, at least to me, because I'm not much of a spicy person, IPAs are like hot sauce. That's what I mean.
IPAs actually cut spicy. So
What I'm trying to say is
it's something that you don't desire. It's something where it's
I guess that was a bad.
It's something where it's I'm not the guy that goes into Wingstop and says, "Give me Atomic because I have balls."
That is exactly how I feel about really, really strong IPAs. People are like, "I want the really strong IPAs because I like to get drunk and I like beer.
I want it so dank I get high at the same time."
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's kind of how I associate.
I get it.
Thank you for the assist.
Yeah. All right, moving into our second segment here. I've got a question for you. Yeah. So, my question is, what product would you stockpile if it was going to be discontinued?
Oreos.
Oreos are a good one. I thought all desserts was my first thought.
Chocolate.
Yes, but then I started getting a little bit more practical.
Are we thinking just not just
all products?
Oh, chicken.
Oh, I was going to say toilet paper.
All right, so hold on.
I go to food immediately.
Do I have to pick a specific chocolate style thing, or just like, can I say chocolate in general?
No, it had to be a specific product.
Okay, then I need to deliberate.
Oh, then you can't stockpile certain things though. Like chicken is something that is in everything that I eat. But I couldn't stockpile it because it would go bad.
You'd have to freeze all of it. And that that would only last you a little while.
And that would burn.
Like a few years. Yeah. Toilet paper, I was like my first thought. And then I started thinking hand sanitizer. Because if we get rid of hand soap, that's fine. But hand sanitizer,
Toilet paper is a waste. You just get like the new like bidet type thing.
That's true. You could get bidets.
There you go.
Mm-hmm.
Bidet.
Oh, I love getting bidet. Sometimes I benight, but mostly I bidet.
Oh, no. It's benign.
He's only mad because he didn't.
I know, right?
No, I was
that
like,
was
I
a kept, total Krager yeah. joke.
But all I'm thinking about is like a benign tumor.
A benign tumor. My bidet is malignant. Ashley, what would you? What would you?
I think I would stockpile on toothpaste.
Oh, that's a good one. I didn't even think of that. Or would you just do? I guess toothpaste is better than mouthwash because it does more.
But what about toothbrushes?
Oh,
because
yeah.
if you didn't have one, what would you? That's bacteria filled.
But if you have the hand sanitizer, this is God's toothbrush.
Actually, when I was at camp,
in the painting, he's like, "Here's my toothbrush."
Yeah, when I was at camp when I was a kid, they wrapped a pine pine needle around a twig, and that was what they used for a toothbrush. And
now
that's
resourceful.
Yeah.
I want those people to be with me in the zombie apocalypse. Are there anything else? I thought the schnitzel at Aldi,
my God.
Because that's my favorite thing ever. I would stop.
Well, like, yours not peanut butter?
Because I love peanut butter, but like, oh, I guess that's true. That would be hard to not. I literally had peanut butter 3 times. I have it at least once daily. I probably should do that.
See, I'm torn between like dark chocolate and Totino's pizza rolls.
You're totally Totino's pizza rolls.
Oh, yeah.
They'll sustain you longer.
No, because I feel like you didn't have those for like a really long time until we went to Walmart. And
because I was like, those are an expenditure I don't need to spend. And then they were on sale.
But how often do you eat dark chocolate?
Whenever I can.
Okay.
Whenever possible.
When it's available to me.
Well, no, like one of my favorite things to do is get like chocolate chips and like the baking section.
Yes.
And keep them in my freezer. And then when I want a little snack is...
I love the dark chocolate baker chips. Those are the best.
I love how he calls it a little snack.
It is a little snack.
It's only like if you threw some peanuts in with it, that's a legit snack. It's only however much you can fit inside your shirt like this.
Yeah. Yeah.
So the whole bag.
The big hand. Yeah. Yeah.
It's my strong hand.
I think that's good. Toothpaste is good. The all the things are good. So
if we're going hygienically, I was thinking like shampoo or all-in-one soap.
I could do without soap probably because I think if you just washed yourself off with water and flowers, you'd be fine.
Mine actually probably would be soap. So from someone who like washes her hands compulsively, soap is probably like when you said hand sanitizer would do and soap wouldn't. I was like, no.
See,
you need soap.
And see, for me, like I have a very dirty job, so like I need like
that's true.
Water
that is true.
Enough.
That's true. I wouldn't be using hand sanitizer after I wipe my butt probably. So
especially
I would need
if you get
soap.
A cut. Butt cut.
Nope. I don't know. I'm like weird when it comes to washing my hands. If my hands even feel slightly dirty, sticky, sweaty, anything, I have to wash my hands. Yep. Hand sanitizer doesn't do it.
Does anyone else's hands start splitting open, or is that just me?
Yeah.
You guys do that too?
Well, I work in
water. Yeah, you work in water all day. I forgot.
Like, I don't, but you can see mine's cracked. Mine's
okay right
last
now.
Last week when I was working with a lot of acetone, yes. But yeah. That was because I was working with acetone.
Yeah. And you know what they say about acetone.
It's toner for your ass.
Yeah, big socks. moving on to our next segment, which is actually something I just want to mention real quick. And it's a segment that I cut from this show, but I'm going to bring it back real fast for just today.
You want to hear a story? Oh, cool. Because it's story time. With Wreck My Podcast.
I did the most Los Angeles thing I've ever done in my life the other day. Ashley, you probably heard me tell the story already, but I don't think Morgan or Craig or you heard me tell it last night, that I did meditation with a group at a networking event I went to with my wife, and it was very weird and awkward and gave me anxiety, and that's the opposite effect of what it's supposed to do.
Not only did you do meditation for the first time, but group meditation sounds
so
terrible.
We went to a rooftop venue and had some cocktails and food to show off this new venue, and me and my wife are hanging out talking to people, and all of a sudden they go, everyone come over here. My spiritual counselor or advisor or spiritual guidance advisor is going to guide us through a group meditation right now that was 20 minutes long. 20 minutes. So she had us all sit down in a circle and close our eyes. And then she started shaking a maraca or whatever the heck it was and being like, envision your heart connected to your lungs and this circle thing. And so you're breathing. And I'm having a panic attack because I'm like, first off, I can't leave because I don't want to be that jerk that just gets up in the middle of this thing and leaves because I don't want to be that guy. So I'm like, I'm stuck. I'm going to die. My heart's pounding so fast. And then she starts playing music and wants us to all stand up and start shaking vigorously for 3 minutes.
Three minutes.
A whole song?
It was a lot of really weird stuff. And I don't have anything against meditation. I think meditation's great when you're alone in your house.
It sounds like something out of Grandma's Boy.
Super weird. It was like the most Los Angeles, like new age weird thing I've ever done in my life.
I feel like when you meditate, the whole purpose of meditation is that you need to be in a safe space. Mm-hmm. Like you need to be comfortable in where you are and who you're with. And if you have 1 second where you're like, that guy behind me, like, is a little sketchy, you're done. Your meditation sesh is toast.
The whole point is to calm yourself.
Right.
And you can't calm yourself when you're in a group of people you don't know doing something you've never done before. Like, it's just so weird. So that's my story time. Just wanted to mention that because that was a weird thing that happened to me. But also, I live in Los Angeles. So, I mean, it's going to happen to all of us eventually. moving on to our Patreon content here. We have two questions this week. First one is from Brian Breaker of the Breaker and Bane Power Hour.
Cool dude.
Rick, my podcast crew, it's your pal Brian Breaker, and I am bringing you a question for this month. It's a big hot topic. Everyone's talking about it, Disney Plus. It launched November 12th. And I've already seen polls you guys have put up on Instagram about which Disney Channel original movie you're going to watch. Here's my question to all of you guys. What is something you're really looking forward to watching on Disney Plus and something you're not looking forward to watching, but you will probably have to watch because of the podcast? You guys keep up the great work. Awesome show. Can't wait to listen to what you guys say.
Thanks, Brian. You're a real pal.
Yeah, you're a champ.
Yeah, he's great. So, guys, what are you looking forward to most on there? Which we probably have watched since we've had it for a week and a half now.
I mean, honestly, I feel like everyone's answer is going to be the Mandalorian.
Let's go away from the Mandalorian.
Yeah, okay, we'll go away from the Mandalorian. That's well known in itself.
Yeah.
It's a nostalgia thing.
Yeah, something nostalgia. What are you looking forward to most? Yeah, Morgan.
So I already watched mine.
Mm-hmm.
It was Lizzie McGuire.
Yes. The series or the movie?
The series.
Okay.
I've seen the movie like
a million
very
times.
Recently.
It was on Amazon Prime for a while. Yeah. I watched it recently,
I've
too.
I've seen it very recently. So not the movie, but I think it was on Netflix recently, too.
Mm-hmm.
Not too long ago. But I saw, yeah, so I watched Lizzie McGuire. Most of it because I took a sick day and I was watching it. Like,
is it
almost
a season, 2 seasons long?
Lizzie McGuire?
It's not super long.
Okay. I think it's two.
It might be two.
My childhood brain's not super long.
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
It wasn't super long.
That's one thing that I've noticed about every series ever that I felt like it was so much longer than it actually was. And then my least favorite, and I don't really, it's like, I know I'll probably watch it because it's nostalgic, but That's So Raven. I didn't love it,
so
but
you're not
I know
excited.
I'm going to watch it.
You're not excited that Cory in the House is coming pretty soon either then?
No, I'm really excited about The Weekenders.
The Weekenders.
And actually American Dragon Jake Long was one
which
that I used to watch like the middle
show.
Of the night.
It was a pretty good one.
And like the dog was just like super wrinkly.
It was like when you thought you were watching anime as a kid, but you weren't watching anime.
That's kind of what it was.
So those are good ones. Craiger, what do you got?
So I would have to say probably Luck of the Irish because I remember absolutely loving that movie. And I can't tell you how long it's been since I've seen it. So I'm excited and nervous because I don't know if it's going to hold up.
I think that one will hold up.
But I'm really excited to watch that. Least favorite. I don't know if I have a least favorite.
That's fine. You could play be Joe this week and not have anything negative.
Well, no, like I just can't think of anything like well, also it's kind of like all the things we're going to do for the podcast, I'm actually going to like want to do. Like everything on our list, I was like, oh, I'm down for it. There hasn't been one thing where I'm like, oh, I don't want
to
watch
I have
that.
A few that I'm not looking forward to. Oh. But we'll get to me at the end. Ashley, what are you looking forward to and not looking forward to?
Well, I have already binged watched it. It was the first thing that went up into my watch list, and it was The Gargoyles.
Oh, Gargoyles is a good one.
I forgot it was on there.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah. Wow, I didn't even think of that.
That was another late night with like American Dragon. That was like one of those ones that I was like, yes.
That was Morgan After Dark. Yep. Gargoyles and American Dragon.
Something that I'm like not or like least excited about is probably watching all of like the CGI kind of live action movies, except for Dumbo. Dumbo's the only one that I'm like super excited to watch. Every other one I'm like, which I can live without.
Have you seen Lady and the Tramp yet?
No.
I've heard good things.
One website said good things, the other website I read said really bad things. Ooh. So we'll find out. But my thing I'm most excited to rewatch, and everyone should watch this if they haven't, is an animated series that was on Disney XD called Tron Uprising.
Ooh.
It is so freaking good. Expands on the Tron universe, which I'm a huge fan. Obviously, I have a tattoo of it. But it's just really good. It's well acted. Elijah Wood is the voice of the main person in it.
I remember hearing about this. I never watched it. You've got to give me something to go watch tonight.
It's a very, very good show, and it's only one season long.
Oh,
so
super easy.
Yeah, super easy to watch. I don't think they ended it very well. They got canceled, so wow. I was kind of bummed about that. But the things I'm not looking forward to is the live-action 101 Dalmatians, which I'll probably get on here.
Is that the old one? Or
the one
with
Glenn Close.
Oh, okay. You didn't like those?
I don't remember liking them, no.
No.
I remember liking them as
also,
a kid.
Also, Beverly Hills Chihuahua, if we have to watch that, I'm going to be upset.
God. That's not a, that's, no, I'm kiboshing that now.
As well as Honey, I Blew Up the Kid.
That's fair.
Should have never been made. Awful.
Okay. I forgot about
Jordan gave me my negatives.
Yeah, I forgot about Gravity Falls, which if you haven't seen Gravity Falls,
it's fun.
Mabel is like low key, I relate to her.
I need to watch that.
They have a lot of like the Gravity Falls shorts and stuff on Disney Plus I saw as well. So that's a good one to dive into. A lot of fun stuff. Also, you guys remember the Disney Channel original movie Cowbells?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Awful.
Sounds,
I don't want to watch
that. Sounds familiar. Was that the one with the two girls?
Yes.
Yeah. Allie and AJ.
The ones that sing something about chemistry or
something.
They sing.
Right? They have a song.
Chemicals react.
That one and then the potential breakup song was like my like.
Rush. Rush was mine.
That one. Yeah.
All right. Anyway.
Anyways.
They have a new one.
Good for them. I said I have two questions, but I'm hanging on for the other one for another thing. But I have a promo here. For people who aren't patrons, here's a reason why you should be a patron. Check it out. Hi-de-ho, good patrons.
Hi-de-ho!
And welcome to this exclusive content just for you. TalkToTransformer.com?
No.
Okay, so there's a thing that's called an AI text generator that's becoming all the rave.
I asked it, is Wreck My Podcast the best podcast ever? The answer was, probably not.
I don't trust it.
I don't trust it either. I asked the question, is Lauren actually gay?
Oh, nice.
Okay. And it says she's not, but she loves to dance, so it's not a surprise.
I just typed in, why is Wreck My Podcast better than the Difference Between Us podcast?
Oh, pulling in the Difference Between Us.
And the answer is, because you can hear the voices of geniuses at work in your favorite podcast.
Yeah. Oh, you know it.
Get bodied.
Oh,
so if you are not a patron, you should really be a patron because you get cool stuff like that every month. So there you go. And Ashley's a patron, so she knows what it's like. Guys, we have a happy birthday segment. Chugga,
choo, choo.
So Ashley's filling in for Joe this week, and it means that Morgan, Craiger, and I are going to be playing against each other on celebrity birthday trivia. So we chime in with our names if we know the answer.
I'm going to forget to say my name.
You also can just go, ma!
I feel like I'm just going to yell out the answer.
As long as it's a name, I guess that works.
I also feel like I was really cocky yesterday, so I'm definitely going to lose this.
All right. Let's see. Let's see if the cockiness is correct.
All right. Let's get it started. So the first one that we have is Alley Cat Strike.
Jordan. Kaylee Cuoco.
Yes.
Yeah. Get body.
She will be 34 on November 30th.
Very nice.
All right. On to number two, since somebody just had to outshine everybody.
Mm-hmm. It's usual.
Good job, Jordan.
Actually, it's Cam's job.
Yeah, it's normally Cam's job. I got to fill in for him.
All right. Fargo, the TV series.
There's a lot of people in that one.
Orange County. King Kong.
Jordan. Martin Freeman?
No.
No. King Kong.
King Kong.
King Kong.
Krager? Probably wrong, but Jack Black.
No.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Fargo. Oh, goodness. I think I know who it is.
I don't think she's in Fargo or Orange County. But the only person I can think of that's in King Kong is Naomi Watts.
No.
Billy Bob Thornton?
No.
Is it Kirsten something?
Is it no. Kirsten Dunst? Is it Billy Ray Cyrus?
No.
Is it Josh Plemons?
No.
Who is it?
It's Colin Hanks.
Oh,
only
God.
The main character of the first season of Fargo, or one of
Dang
them.
Dang it!
I haven't seen two of those things. I didn't even know. I have no idea.
I don't really remember. I remember him in Jumanji.
Yeah. All right.
And he'll be 42 on November 24th.
Go to Colin.
All right. Next one is Scary Movie. What's your number?
Oh, Krager. Anna Faris.
Yes.
Oh, nice.
Anna Faris.
I forgot about
nice.
That.
How did you? I was like, as soon as she said, what's your number? I'm like, they're going
to
get it.
I don't even know.
If she had said mom, I'd be like, yes.
I don't even know what's your
number. I tried
number.
To keep mom away from it because that's like what she's been yeah, right
we,
now.
We always trying to keep our mothers away. Though.
Yeah. No
the
moms.
Last one was going to be the house bunny.
That would have.
Yeah, that would have given it away.
All right.
Tommy Lee Jones. Oh, that was a different movie.
I'll have the Mahi Mahi, but just one Mahi. I'm not very hungry.
All right. Launch their own cooking website on November 4th.
Krager? Jessica Alba?
No. Co-host of Lip Sync Battle.
Oh!
Morgan. Chrissy Teigen.
Yes.
Yeah.
I wish I would have waited.
Chrissy Teigen will be 34 on November 30th.
We all got 1 point.
All right. Married with Children.
Oh, God, what's it?
Mars Attacks. Don't Tell Mom the Babysitter's Dead.
Jordan, wait, no, that's his name in the show. Al Bundy.
No.
Is it that person?
No.
Oh.
Krager.
Oh.
Christina Applegate.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes!
Because those were the two I was
I didn't remember her in the other movies, but I'm all like, that's the only name I remember.
Yeah.
Christina Applegate will be 48 on November 25th.
48?
What do you think her gate's made out of?
Apples.
Okay.
All right. Voice actor on Gremlins. Little Monsters, Deal or No Deal.
Jordan, Howie Mandel.
Yes.
Ah.
Howie Mandel will be 64 on November 29th.
Yeah, buddy.
All right.
I feel his pain.
Marshall.
Jordan, Jason Segel.
No.
We are Marshall.
42.
Craig. Didn't say my full name.
Oh, he still got his hand on the bishop.
I didn't say my full name.
Okay.
I'm not
going on, yeah.
Black Panther.
Oh, Krager.
What's his name, though, Krager?
T'Challa.
Morgan. Chadwick Boseman.
That's yes. it.
Dang yeah. it.
We all have
I,
two.
I almost said, all right. What's his name?
Matthew McConaughey.
Because we are Marshall.
Yeah, yeah.
Chadwick Boseman will be 42 on November 29th.
Gotcha.
All right.
All right.
Is it 2-2-2?
It's 2-2-2.
Dang.
We're like a girl in ballerina.
I'm so here for that.
They had a talk show released on Netflix in 2017. They have a best-selling book called Everything All at Once. Science Guy.
Jordan. Bill Nye.
Yes.
Oh!
Are you using they as the preferred pronoun or just
sure.
so we didn't know it was a he?
Both.
Okay.
Bill Nye will be 64 on November 27th.
Nice.
And to be fair, that was the hardest one to look for stuff for.
Yeah.
Because all of his shows is like Bill Nye Saves the World.
Yeah.
Bill Nye the Science Guy. The Eye of Nye. And I'm like, cool.
Everything has his name in
yeah.
it.
Yeah. What a narcissist.
The Bill is Nye.
Okay. Next one is Eyes Without a Face.
So that sounds scary.
I don't even know what that is.
Rebel Yell.
Jordan. Billy Idol.
Yes. Billy Idol will be 64 on November 30th.
Yeah. How many more do we have?
It's pretty much over.
One and a bonus. If
one and a bonus.
Yeah, and you have the lead.
I have 4-2.
Yeah.
All right.
We can still joust.
Terminator, Dark Fate, Scream Queens, the TV series.
Jordan. Linda Hamilton.
No.
Okay.
And Rock of Ages.
I don't remember her name. It's the main girl. She was in the back to back trailers at the movie theater. She's a skinny girl. Skinny one. Blonde girl.
Are you thinking about Julianne Hough?
Sure.
No.
No, not Julianne Hough.
No. Well, she's in...
I know who he's thinking of, but I don't think...
The main character of the new Terminator movie.
The girl who's like the Terminator?
Yeah, because she... Yeah.
I don't know her
the
name.
The one who is the Terminator.
I just remember she's in Black Mirror.
I'm trying to think of who's in Rock of Ages.
I don't even know her name. I wouldn't even know.
Well, it's a guy anyway.
Oh.
Oh!
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Chadwick Boseman.
The only one I know who's in Rock of Ages is Tom Cruise. And I know he's not in Terminator.
Oh, so is he?
Hold on. I got this. It is Aldous Snow.
No.
Is it the dude who's a Terminator can turn into two Terminators?
I don't know what he was in Terminator. That was just like the biggest one that I could find.
Uh-huh.
It's Diego Boneta.
Yeah, that's him.
And he'll be 29 on November 29th.
Morgan and Krager should do the bonus for whoever doesn't get last place.
Yeah, sure.
So fight to the death?
Fight to the death.
Yeah. Okay.
We'll see who's sleeping on the couch.
The Watch?
It's me.
Okay.
Dodgeball. There's Something About Mary.
Krager. Ben Stiller.
Yes.
Yeah.
I was going to say it, but then I was like, I feel like this is a trend.
And Ben Stiller will be 54 on November 30th.
Well, that was good. That was fun. I got to tell you guys something to ponder. Can a hearse carrying a corpse drive in the carpool lane?
I don't know. The song is short. I'm gonna stop now.
Was that a news article? I don't know.
I think I read about that somewhere.
So let's do Uber facts with Morgan,
oh,
right?
With Krager's girlfriend.
Yeah, here we go.
Welcome to Uber Facts with Krager.
Girlfriend.
The segment where Krager says some
girlfriend.
Stuff.
Girlfriend.
We say some stuff, and some stuff happens. Now here he is.
She.
Take it away, Krager.
Girlfriend. All right. So, we haven't done this segment in a while.
Yeah, my bad.
I'm so nervous I'm going to mess it up for the
Yeah,
record.
So Morgan, you're giving us four things. Three true, one fake?
Correct.
Cool. All right, let's hear them.
During the ancient Persian Empire, men would debate ideas while sober, then again while drunk.
Mmm, sounds very Persian.
Okay.
Was there a lot of cologne involved too?
Using your non-dominant hand for mundane tasks, like eating cereal, opening doors, etc., for 3 weeks can improve your balance.
Okay. I could see that.
Yeah.
As a U.S. citizen, if you find an unclaimed island anywhere in the world containing guano, you can take it in the name of the United States.
Interesting.
Isn't guano bird poop?
I was just going to say that's bat poop.
Bat poop.
Bat poop. Okay.
Interesting.
Oh, yeah. Guano.
In 2017, five nurses from Denver were suspended after they opened the body bag of a dead man to admire the size of his penis.
Oh, man, those are hard.
Only the last one. Rigor mortis.
Oh, wow.
I'm not going to state my opinions because I already have ruled two of them out for surezies, but I'm not going to spoil it for you guys.
Okay. I think the hand one's real. I feel like that's a thing.
I think it's the bat poop.
I think so too, but that's almost too weird to not be real. I'm going to go with the bat poop, too. The guano. The island guano.
You're on bat poop?
Yeah.
I will go rigor mortis because I feel like there's so much she could change in that one.
So, oh no, it just went to the top of my pictures.
Dang
Hold
it.
On. You're all wrong.
Oh!
Oh!
Heart.
So, the it was the hand one.
Oh,
that's what I was like for sure about.
And what's really cool about this one is like it's super interesting because you would never think that this is what it actually improves. So using your non-dominant hand actually for 2 weeks, not three, can improve your self-control.
Oh.
Learning to regulate.
Like not eating that last piece of pie?
Yeah.
Perfect for Thanksgiving.
So learning to regulate impulsive responses. So learning to regulate impulsive responses is no different than learning a new skill, such as playing the piano, and small exercises can help tame levels of aggression.
All right, I'm going to start working my left hand a little bit more.
See, like, that definitely played into my vanity because, like, I pride myself in being very, like, have good hand-eye coordination and, like, very well-balanced. And also because I work, like, with tools and stuff, I'm actually really good at doing stuff with my left hand.
So I purposely chose balance because I knew that he would be like, oh, I'm very coordinated and balanced and I'm very good with my left hand.
I fell for it.
And then I also thought that it was, like, some of the, like, cool things about the other facts. So the Persian Empire one. So they believed an idea that sounded acceptable and both states had to be a good idea. Oh. So that's why they debated both.
Yeah, I've heard that one before. I knew that. See, my two that I was like for sure are real are the Persian one and the hand one.
Oh, okay. I knew the nurse one. That was like another article that I just read somewhere on
the
Facebook.
Nurse one was just
out of the corner of my eye, as soon as I was like, I'm going with the nurse one, I saw your head like this, but I'm all like, I've committed. I cannot cheat.
And then the guano one, the only caveat to claiming it is it can't be occupied or within the jurisdiction of another government.
Interesting.
So you can claim the island or the guano?
You can claim the island in the name of America.
As long as there is guano.
As long as there is guano. And it's unclaimed and it's not in occupied or within
that's a
the
lot
jurisdiction.
Of stuff that you have
well,
to
no,
figure
like,
out.
All that's fine, but it's like, why is guano the determining factor?
I know. I'd be like, well, can I take this island back? It's got poop all over it.
I would just find a bat and be like, my island, I'm Batman.
Yeah, does the guano have to be there before you get there, or can you just bring a bat with you?
I'm just going to buy some guano off Amazon.
You just have to find guano. Okay. Oh, it just has to contain guano. So literally the exact words are containing guano poop.
Okay.
So
I'm
going to
order guano off Amazon and carry it with
go.
Me everywhere because
go.
Amazon probably has guano.
Probably. Yeah. And you get it in 2 days.
No, one day now.
So,
well, it's like
that's
things.
True. Some
I got my
one
book.
Day.
I just ordered a book. I got it one day.
So, guys, we're going to rocket through the rest of this. So, I'm skipping the jingles. What are you stoked on this week?
I just got my teeth cleaned.
Nice.
And I'm really happy about it because it's like I love going to the dentist because I'm really weird. And my teeth are like really smooth and it's my favorite thing.
Nice.
She
dentist.
Just,
okay.
She just named, if I went to the dentist, that would be my hashtag problem because I hate the dentist.
Mm-hmm. But what are you stoked on?
My stoked on is that because of my love for Bagel Boyz and mentioning them on the podcast, they actually like, hey, we heard you guys talking about us. Next time you want to like hang out, like come on over, just say you're from Wreck My Podcast and we might hook you up a little
bit. What's weird is they didn't hear us talking about them because they started following us.
Do we know why?
Before we even released that episode. And I said, hey, funny story. We talked about you on our podcast. And then they were like, cool, come on in. We'll hook you up.
Did they tell us like I'm going to go in.
I probably hashtag something like SCV or something like that. And they just went for those hashtags.
Who's a person?
Josh.
So
was his name.
Next time I go, I'm going to try and talk to Josh and be like, I want to know how you heard about it.
Yeah,
because, like,
I'm curious too.
I've been a huge Bagel Boyz fan for years.
No,
and
you know what it was? They started following my BS and Craft Beer. And I told them about the podcast. And then they started following the podcast.
Gotcha.
It's a whole big thing. It's a big thing. But yes, Bagel Boyz.
Yes, my love for Bagel Boyz. I contend they are the best bagel joint in SoCal. That I've tasted.
Of all the bagel joints in all over.
That I have tasted. I can't super claim all of SoCal because I haven't tasted everything in SoCal, but that I have tasted, they are the best in my opinion.
So I will take your word for it.
The thing that Kevin, I don't know if you mentioned this on the other podcast where you talk about Bagel Boyz, but sourdough is Kev's favorite.
Sourdough
bagels
are
the
best.
Yeah, Craiger, if you want to send him a gift, a whole bag of sourdough bagels.
Yep, that's the one.
I will gladly, if I had to be overweight, it would be because of bagels.
There also, his go. Birthday is in June. Just
there you go.
For the record.
Everyone, mark it down.
My birthday
right
is every day.
Yeah. Ashley, what are you stoked on?
Since it's technically Monday, I'm super excited that I get Thursday and Friday off of work.
Me too.
It's the thing to be thankful for. Thanksgiving. No. You don't get that, Morgan?
Oh,
that's
had some,
my hashtag, bro.
She's had some bull spit.
That's a bummer.
On. Yeah, her,
that's a bummer.
Her boss is a hashtag douchebag.
I asked him for a half day on Friday so that I could do Christmas tree decorating with my grandma.
Mm-hmm. And did they give it to you?
He said maybe. I feel like if someone asks you, like, you know, can I do something with Friday. My grandma? And you say no, you're just automatically
you
like,
should,
the worst.
If you call him, if you're like, man, that's really Kevin Spacey of you, I feel like that might help.
Yeah. Or
horrible
just,
bosses, remember?
Or you can just be sick. That, I'm not feeling so hot today.
There's you can tell the story.
Well, so here's the thing about that is I have 8 sick days left.
Use them.
But that's the problem is that I asked him, I think it came up in conversation. I was like, oh, so I'll take a sick day the Friday after Thanksgiving and then Christmas Eve. And that's how I'll kind of use them because they're going to expire if I don't use them. And he was like, a sick day. He's like, you can't plan a sick day.
Yeah, you can.
I was like,
mental health.
It's all the same.
Yeah,
like it's all the same. Cat, like
it's all PTO.
Time off. Yeah. I'm like, it doesn't matter. And he's like, that's not how that works. And I was like, okay.
Then just call in that day.
No, yeah. But I told her like, even if he has a conversation, as long as it's not like multiple days in a row, you can just call in that morning and say, hey, I'm sick.
Yeah,
and they cannot do anything about that.
No, but they don't need a doctor.
But on top of that, like she's being very cordial. Like she talked to other people. And can I say, talk to the person with the thing?
No, maybe don't say that.
Okay.
But I did.
Tune back next week.
I did plan my dentist, and I'm going to unabashedly say this. I planned my dentist appointment on a Monday, and I am going to take a sick day because technically that's doctor profession and applies as sick.
That's a
and
sick
I'm
day.
Like, bye.
That's tooth sickness. Tooth sickness.
I'm upset. I'm like,
no, I'd be
upset.
No, I can't air things because professionalism, but like situation is hum-a-hum-a-hum.
I get it. So what I'm stoked on is that System of a Down said they're going to be touring in 2020.
Yes!
But guess what is the problem is that it's not in America.
What?
Where's
none
it
of it's in America. It's all over in like Europe and Russia or
I
something
I guess
like
we're
that.
Doing Wreck My Europe.
Yep, exactly. All right.
Because I've yet to see them live.
We
Same.
I first.
Did you get to do your Stoked On This?
Yeah.
She said Thanksgiving.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's my favorite holiday too.
Yes.
It's not my favorite holiday.
Oh, okay.
But she likes getting tired.
Yeah, you probably like Halloween. Mm-hmm. You like horror. Yes. Yeah, that makes sense.
My whole thing is usually I always have to work that Friday.
Mm-hmm. And
nice.
Now I don't.
Nice. I wrote my name with my left hand.
Good job.
And it looks like a 5-year-old.
It looks
all
right.
Good.
I just picked
it's
this
legible.
Up with my left hand.
It's slightly legible.
I
all
can
right.
read it.
Craiger, do you have some trivia for us? We'll ring this bad boy out with some trivia.
Yeah.
And we will have the shortest episode of Around a Round Table in history.
So, in honor of Disney Plus, I'm doing it on Disney Trivia.
Nice.
I tried to do Disney Channel Trivia, but I couldn't find
that.
Well, I
did Disney Channel original movies last week.
Yeah.
This is going to be who can chime in the quickest to get the
probably.
Answer.
Probably.
Maybe.
Probably.
Unless he chose really hard and difficult.
Some of them were easy, some of them were harder, I think.
Okay.
So, question number one.
One.
What Disney movie was the first full-length animated feature
Ashley.
To be produced? Ashley.
Snow White.
Yes.
No.
I was trying to throw it off because it's produced in the United States. I was like, maybe that might make people think.
She's except, not going to let you finish. You said first.
Yeah, and except
it's Snow
Walt,
White.
Walt Disney didn't live anywhere else but the United States.
That's the first one. Oh. Yay, 1937. Yay. Okay, question number two. What popular Disney character makes a cameo appearance as a stuffed animal in Frozen? A. Donald Duck. B. Mickey Mouse. C. Stitch.
Jordan. Donald Duck.
Incorrect.
I've never seen Frozen.
And D. Congratulations, by the way.
Yeah.
Dumbo.
Ashley. Is it Stitch?
It is not. Morgan, you have Mickey Mouse and Dumbo.
That's hard because one's obvious and one's not.
I'm going to go with Dumbo.
That was a Dumbo choice. It was Mickey. Point for me.
You have chose Dumbo.
One point.
I would have never expected Mickey.
I know. That's why.
Oh, that's
so
funny.
Obvious.
I would
think it would be Donald.
How did they make,
I expected
how did they make so many billions of dollars without me going to see that movie? I mean, come on.
It's the magic of Frozen.
I guess so. Number trace.
You didn't do a good job of freezing them out, am I right?
Oh, my assets
all right.
were frozen.
Anyways, number three, what does the Little Mermaid call the fork in her collection
Ashley.
Of human objects? Ashley.
A dinglehopper.
It is a dinglehopper.
I was going to go ding. I thought it was going to be one of the fox say.
Oh, yes. Always funny, Jordan. Number four.
Number four.
What was the only character in Disney's Alice in Wonderland that did not appear in Lewis Carroll's book? Books. A. The doorknob. B. The dormouse. C. The Queen of Hearts. Or D. Alice's sister.
Jordan.
Jordan.
Ashley.
It was the dormouse.
Incorrect. Dang.
The sister.
Incorrect. Dang. Morgan, you have.
Oh, it's going to end up being the Queen,
the Queen of Hearts
probably.
Or the doorknob.
I read that book too. That's the saddest thing. I feel like it's the Queen of Hearts.
Is that your answer?
Oh, God. Well, I mean, I already said it.
It is the doorknob.
Oh, Craiger's going to run away with this one.
Holy
What's
cow.
The score?
Two, Ashley.
I thought for sure. I don't know.
You're
How
beautiful.
Is it?
All right, move it along.
He like incepted me. He was like,
I did.
Like it's the Queen of
you
Hearts.
See, you see what I did there? You see what I did there? I'm taking it down with me.
It says, the doorknob was also one of the few characters in Wonderland to show any sympathy for Alice.
Oh.
Never listen to my ignorance,
Good
Morgan.
Job, doorknob.
Yeah. Question number whatever.
Five.
What is the name of the pub that Flynn brings Rapunzel to in Tangled?
Morgan. The Snuggly Duckling.
That is correct.
Wow, the Snuggly Duckling.
Unabashful, one question I knew Morgan would get right.
There you go. He had to throw you a softball.
He knows I love that movie.
So. I haven't seen that movie in so long.
I know the entire song that they sing in the Snuggly Duckling.
Well, there you go.
I have watched it with her. It is true. Question number six. What is Boo's real name in Monsters, Inc.? A. Mary. B.
Ashley.
Morgan.
C.
I think it's Mary.
It is.
It is Mary.
Yeah.
I couldn't remember if it was Mary or Anne.
She.
My brain immediately.
Although her name is never spoken out loud, she signs her drawings with Mary.
Ryan Budge just asked this question, which is why I should have known it.
Yep. What is the score now?
2-2-2-0 Jordan.
Wow. Number seven. Right?
Yeah.
Seven. How many eggs does Gaston eat for breakfast?
Morgan. Six.
Incorrect.
Damn it.
A, 48. B, 36. C, 24. Or D,
Jordan. 36.
Incorrect.
Dang it, Morgan. You incepted me.
Ashley.
Reverse
incepted. Ashley.
It's D, right?
D is correct. 6D.
I knew there was a 6 in there.
6D. 60 eggs. 5 dozen eggs.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot of eggs.
I guess that's how you get those muscles.
Yep.
I don't even like, I barely liked cooked eggs.
I thought Ashley wrong. Screwed herself because she didn't let me say D. So I was like, uh-oh, am I about to get another point? But no.
No, I just saw that somewhere when I was looking for the trivia for you guys. It had a 6 in there, but I was like, no, is it 60 or is it 16?
I could see like 12.
All right. Are we on 8 or 9?
Eight.
What was the first Disney animated film to feature a completely original storyline? The Fox and the Hound. Mona. The Lion King.
Jordan. The Lion King.
Correct.
Yeah, technically, but there's a huge debate about it because they ripped off a lot of Kimba, the White Lion, which was an anime. But yeah, it's technically the first. I'm on the board.
You got a point.
All right, number 9. Right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Numbers are hard.
Indeed.
Some scenes of Wonderland creatures and the forest fire in Bambi are actually unused footage from what other Disney movie?
Jordan. Snow White.
Incorrect.
Dang.
A. Pinocchio. B. Peter and the Wolf. C. Snow White. Or D. Fantasia.
I'm glad that one that I said was at least on the list.
Morgan.
Ashley.
Fantasia.
Incorrect.
Damn it.
Is it the
one that no one knows?
The wolf one?
It is not Peter and the Wolf. It is Pinocchio.
Oh, really? My gosh. So Craiger is tied with Ashley for first right now.
Oh, my gosh.
Last question. I have no chance of winning.
It's okay.
Oh, man. Some scenes of the woodland creatures and the forest fire in Bambi are unused footage.
You just read this.
No, I was hoping you'd give me more information, but didn't. Sorry. Okay, number 10. What actor provided the voice of Hercules in the Spanish language version of the Disney film? A, Mark Anthony. B, Ricky Martin. C, Enrique Iglesias. Or D, Matt LeBlanc.
Jordan.
Ashley. Jordan.
Enrique Iglesias.
Incorrect.
Ricky Martin.
Correct.
Oh.
I was going to go with Ricky Martin.
And Ashley pulls ahead and she wins. Do I still have your... Here you go. But that was just a grudge match. So you didn't win the title. You just won the knowledge of knowing that you beat us all in Disney trivia.
Question. And
yes.
What were you going to play if I won? Exactly.
I didn't put anything
in
there.
You weren't ready.
I wasn't ready. I apologize.
It's okay. He wasn't ready last time
hear,
when I won.
Do you guys want to hear the bonus? Ready.
Sure. What's the bonus?
What Disney movie was the first full-length animated feature to be nominated for an Oscar for Best Picture?
Ashley. Wait a second.
Yeah, do you want me to read the
nope,
options?
Nope, can't now.
Was it Toy Story?
Incorrect.
Dang it. We
have that wasn't Disney. That was Pixar.
That's why I was like,
The
oh,
Little Mermaid,
no.
The Jungle Book, Beauty and the Beast, The Lion
Jordan.
King.
Beauty and the Beast.
That is correct.
Yeah.
In 1991, it lost to Silence of the Lambs.
Oh,
yes.
Wow. Very similar movies.
And a win for horror.
But it did win the Golden Globe for Best Picture.
Oh, who cares about the Golden Globes?
Facts.
Here we go. So that's the episode. A little bit shorter, but you know what they say, short, sweet, and to the point. Short, sweet, and succulent. Go check out all our episode or show notes down below. Find ways to... Go find ways to support us financially and stuff. And, you know, go find ways to support us financially down there because we're such a professional podcast and I don't do anything wrong on any podcast ever and mess up any times. Also, thanks to Ben from Petrified Gumba Music for making our Stoked On This song, even though we didn't play it. He's a cool guy. Go check out PetrifiedGumbaMusic.com. Come back on Wednesday to listen to us talk either about Brink or Smart House. I don't know which episode I'm putting up first, but one's going to be 1 week, one's going to be the week after. So go ahead and check that out. It'll be cool beans, as the kids say. Thank you to my guests for being here with their clean teeth. And thank you to our listeners, because without you, we wouldn't have a reason to hang out around a table every week. Okay, goodbye.
Goodbye from my shiny teeth and me.
I appreciate each and every one of you.
See you later, alligators.
Hopefully it goes well.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like it could either be a huge bust or it could be a lot of fun.
Well, I'm just like, I don't know how to feel about it.
Like, because you're nervous about it?
I'm like, I don't know. Like, I'm not really terrible. I'm not, like, terribly nervous because, like, we just do the normal thing. I'm, like, trying to think of, like, stuff we can, like, our show as it stands right now isn't super...
Inclusive. Well, we're going to have to change it to be a little
more
interactive.
I'm trying to think
of like... So, like, I'm going to need you to bring, like, 3 rounds of Uber Facts with Craigor, and then I'm going to bring, like, 3 rounds of trivia, and then Joe can do happy birthday and maybe something else, and then Cam can do something, too. And so then
I had this idea.
Yeah.
We should go to Target and try and find if there's a cheap option of, like, a similar to a belt and legit do trivia with, like, we pick out some members of the audience.
So the cheapest option is, like, $20 is the problem.
$5 from each of us.
I guess that's true.
That's really
that's
cheap.
A good idea. But
and
they
then,
also
like, we give it to and we.
But they win beer.
Okay.
And they win shirts and stuff. So
okay,
they're getting things for winning.
Yeah. Okay.
And I figure what I'll do is I'll bring Wreck My Podcast stickers, and for the losers they'll get a sticker.
Okay.
Because you know Wreck My Podcast are a bunch of losers.
Yeah.